Sensors are integrated using a generalized admittance control strategy. This involves three atal expressions. The first expression corresponds to the model of the sensor measurements. This explains how the measurements is related to joint and feature variable skew, and also to the time variable. The second expression expresses the actual measurement coming from the sensor, and the third expression expresses the desired target for the sensor value. If we then map this to the task function, then we see that the Jacobian corresponds to the partial derivatives of the model, while the value of the task function corresponds to the difference between the measurement and the target, the error between the measurement and the target. And the feedforward is still derived from the partial derivatives of the model. So it's clear that from the model we only use its partial derivatives, we never use the value of this model. Using this admittance control strategy, we can easily implement force torque control, for example, to kinesthetically teach a robot application, or for example, for in the screw compressor assembly case. Also, in the cheese application, we use these admittance constraints, for example, for this distance between the tool and the cheese. This cheese decrusting application had many more constraints. It has it runs through the surface and it measures the points on the surface, it models the surface, then there is a constraint that imposes the position of the robots on this trajectory, while there is also a constraint maintaining the pitch of the robot such that the laser sensors always remain in range while still allowing some flexibility in case of joint velocity limits or other constraints in the environment. And this approach also allows for automatic compensation of the time delays in the control loop because these laser sensors are in fact looking ahead. And also in this application, there is a smooth and fast transition between the approach and retract of the cutting trajectory. And this is based upon the weights, changing weights that have an explicit dependency on time, where then the feed forward is automatically computed. Another interesting thing is when we have conflicting admittance and position constraints. If you have a position and a force constraint in the same direction, the resulting behavior will be a virtual spring with a damping that's sufficient to maintain the system stable. And this impedance that we specify there, we specify this using conflicting position and force constraints, and in fact specifying impedance in this way is in fact easier than specifying impedance using a six-dimensional stiffness matrix. For example, you have this application on your right-hand side where in the left there is a vision sensor measuring the corner of the plate, and there is a constraint that wants to maintain the position of the plate on top of the blue sheet. On the other hand, the human is also helping to manipulate the plate and is exerting forces on the plate in order to manipulate the robot. When now the human starts to pull away from the point that's observed by the camera, he will feel a kind of spring-like behavior. While if the human is more rotating around this point, he will have a more force-following behavior. And so in this way, we can already specify quite complex impedances in a very simple and intuitive way. And that's an approach that we use a lot in shared control. Also, we have a skin sensor, which contains 400 cells that measure both distance and forces. Of course, 400 constraints would be a little bit too much for ATADL, and therefore we use a kind of data reduction approach so that we can summarize these cells in a small number of ATADL constraints. And in this way, we can successfully integrate these cells in the application that interacts with the human. Another application is contour following. Contour following has a long history from the task frame formalism, and this formalism is quite powerful, but can be still completely formulated within Etazel, such that we can combine this task frame task like contour following with other constraints in Etazel that, for example, limit joint velocities or whatever. This example is further elaborated in another keynote in this workshop.